This is Chapter 1, Resources and Development. We are taking the multiple choice questions here. The first one is resources which are surveyed and their quantity and quality have been determined for utilization is. The answer is developed resources. Answer is developed resources. Second one is, which one of the following soil is ideal for growing cotton? And the answer is regur soil, regur, kali mrida, black soil. In which of the following states is overgrazing responsible for land degradation? The answer here is, it's Punjab and Haryana. Punjab and Haryana. That is overgrazing. So overgrazing is not Punjab and Haryana. I'm so sorry. It's Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Punjab and Haryana because of over irrigation. But Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan for overgrazing. Atyadhik Pashu Charan. Which one of the following statements is true about the term resources? The answer is, they are the functions of human activities. Which one of the following type of resource is iron ore? The answer is, non-renewable resource it is. Non-renewable resource. Under which of the following types of resources the tidal energy can be put to? Tidal energy. It is replenishable. It is because of the movement of attraction of moon. So tide will always come. Next is soil formed by intense leaching is intense leaching. It is laterite soil. You will find it in Kerala area where the rainfall is more than 200 centimeter per annum. Fallow land refers to it is cultivable land not cultivated for a season in order to regain its fertility. When a crop is grown, the soil loses its fertility, so it is being left. And it will be cultivated later on. That is called fallow land. Now the next question is, method of growing long strip of grass between the crops. It refers to what? The answer here is, it's ninth. So the answer is strip cropping. So cropping is done here in strips and in between we grow grasses. In order to just avoid or de-strengthen the speed of the wind. Next is resources which are found in a region but have not been initialized. So what is the answer for this? Resources which are found in a region but have not been utilized. The answer is potential resources. Potential resources. Which of the following factors involves the transformation of things into a resource? And the answer is, it's actually all of the above. Physical environment, technology, human beings, institutions. Renewable resources are those, the answer here is, which are renewed by physical, chemical and mechanical processes. Which one of the following is not a community resource? Which one is not a community resource? The answer is a car. Car can be yours. You know, you buy it, you register it. So you, everyone have access to public parks, library, community hall, but not to your car. Territorial waters of India extends to? And the answer, because we are given in nautical miles, So we are going to take the answer as 12 nautical miles, which is equivalent to 22.2 kilometers. Find out which one of the following is a stock. The answer is biofuels. These are stocks. The first International Earth Summit was held in Brazil, Rio de Janeiro. There is enough for everybody's need, but not for anybody's greed. Who said this? Mahatma Gandhi, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. He said that. The area brought under cultivation in a year is called, it is called as net sown area. And the most widespread soil covering the northern plains and eastern coastal plains. Who am I? The answer is D. Alluvial soil. Next is resources which are non-renewable but can be recycled. These are called. The answer is recyclable resources. The most widespread relief feature of India is, and what is the answer? The answer is plains, most widespread relief feature. The current net sown area of India in 2002-03 was, and the answer is 43.4%. The state having maximum net sown area in India is Punjab, almost 80% area. Next, land left without cultivation for one or less than one agricultural year is called as, the answer is current fallow land. The present percent of area under forests, we just talked about this, answer is B, 22.57%. The factor responsible for maximum land degradation is, the answer is human activities. Then we have, which agent is responsible for maximum land degradation? The answer is water. Water is the most, because you know, wherever water goes, it has speed and it has the ability to attract the soil, and then it takes the soil with itself. That is soil erosion it causes. Soil is formed by the process of, and the answer is C, weathering. Actually, weathering, erosion, all these are, you know, all are these one or the other factors, but the most, you can say, significant one is weathering. Supply a technical term for the dead and decomposed material found on the top soil. And the answer is humus. The old alluvial soil is known as, it is known as bangar. The new one is called as khadar. Which of the following statements is true for black soil? The answer is all of the above. It has larger portion of clay. It can retain moisture for a long time. It develops crack during summer, which helps in aeration. And then cotton grows best in this soil. Red color of soil is due to, the red color of the soil is due to, the answer is, it is rich in iron compounds. The denudation of the soil cover and washing down of soil by various agents are known as, the answer is soil erosion. The land consisting of many gullies and ravines are called, and these are known as bad land. Terrace cultivation can be used to control soil erosion in hill slopes. So if you have a hill slope, then we can have a terrace cultivation like this. So step farming, terrace cultivation, and this contoured plowing, all these are the solution to the soil erosion on these hill slopes. 36. Strip cropping refers to, it is growing of strips of grass in between the crops. 37. Erosion of the topsoil when water flows as a sheet over large areas down the slope is called as, the answer is sheet erosion. Which one of the following statement is correct as regards to international resources? And it is resources which are regulated by international institutions, international resources. Which one of the following methods is ideal for controlling land degradation in coastal areas and in deserts? The answer is planting of shelter belts. Means if we have trees like this, it is going to stop, or you can say reduce the speed of the wind or air, and then the soil erosion etc. will not take place. So this planting of shelter belts is growing of the tree in lines. Which type of soil is suitable for the growth of cashew nut? The answer is red laterite soil. Arid soil are less fertile. Arid soil are less fertile as, the answer is it lacks humus and moisture. It lacks humus and moisture. Plowing along the contour lines can accelerate the flow of water, deaccelerate the flow of water, accelerate the force of winds, deaccelerate the force of winds. So the answer is deaccelerate the flow of water. Badlands or ravines are found in, the answer is Chambal Basin. So this is the answer key of the multiple choice questions we just took. So thank you so much. Take care of yourself.